Shalom, shalom, and welcome to OCN Believathon 2017. I'm telling you, we have come this far by faith in God and in His Word. OCN, Open Door Communication Network. It is the voice of the Lord thundering the nations of the world with the gospel of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach, and we are so grateful. We know this is not by might nor by power. It's only by the Spirit of God. We want to begin with thanking every one of you that's been given and you've been praying for OCN. You will never have any regrets. And everywhere you have supported OCN, be it through your prayers, be it through your giving, I'm here to tell you that your giving will never be ignored. It will never go unpaid by the Lord Himself. So I want you to get ready for your harvest. This is a good ground. It is indeed a vision that is bigger than all of us. And we are going to the nations of the world. I want you to see some of the things about OCN. And I want this on the screen, please, if you can, let's show this on the screen so the people will know the vision. And so we are 24/7 days Christian television station. And in accordance with the word of the Lord that the Lord gave to us in Psalm 29, the station is the voice of the Lord. Mm-hmm. It is not the voice of human beings. It is the voice of the Lord through all the different hosts, through all the different programs, thundering through the waters, thundering through the Atlantic Ocean, the Indian Ocean, the Pacific Ocean, thundering around the nations of the world with the good news of our Lord and our Master, the King of Kings, that is returning back again to this earth. That is what OCN is all about. That people will hear the gospel. Those that do not know him, they will know him and they will be saved. And those that do know him, they will be strengthened by the word that will go forth continually, day in, day out. Days and nights, 24 hours. And we are 3 years strong. Oh my God, give it up.
Amen.
Give it up. Amen. And I tell you, is the doing of the Lord. Now the next thing I want you to see here is the update for OCN television. For those of you that do not know, OCN is on Galaxy 19 satellite, and you see the frequency. We are in United States, in Canada, in Mexico. And yes, OCN TV just started in Africa 2 months ago.
Yeah.
Amen. And that is growing strong. And we are believing God to go to Middle East. That's right. OCN is also on Optu satellite in Australia. And OCN has great YouTube channel, 24 hours. OCN is live now on Facebook. As you are hearing me, we are live.
Amen.
You go to OCN Facebook, actually go to your Facebook and slash OCN TV, capital letters, and we are live. And we want you to talk back to us. We want you to say something to us, encourage us. We want you to tell us you're praying for us, and we want to hear that you also want to donate to OCN to reach the world. OCN is on Roku platform. So if you have any internet in your home and you have the device called Roku, you can see OCN television 24 hours in your home.
Amen.
And OCN is also live streaming. You can go to www.ocnbroadcasting.com and watch live. You will see us 24 hours, 7 days a week. And we give God the praise. Oh, let's celebrate our Lord. Yeah. Amen, 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 amen. Now, for the OCN Progress, we are reaching over 61 countries in 5 continents.
Amen.
Over 120 million viewers. We give God the praise.
Hallelujah.
You know, the other day we got 2 mails from Malaysia. I'm telling you, I just looked at those mails over and over and over. I said, Lord, you are too much. So we are reaching the Asian nations. And we are also, we have a program that is strictly for the Thais, those from Thailand, those that speak Thai language. We have a Spanish program. We also have a French program from Bishop Osborne.
Amen.
That's right, that's right. We have a lot of teaching programs. We have Christian news. We have... Also, are you ready for this? We have OCN University on the air every week.
Amen.
That's right. And so this is a strong network. And I'm telling you, the anointing of God is in this place.
Amen.
The anointing of God is not measured by how many years you've been on the air or how tall you are or what color. Anointing of God is measured by the Holy Ghost that's in us.
Amen.
Amen. And so this TV station is strong in teaching of the word. And I'm telling you, the Lord is mighty and strong in this station. Oh, let's celebrate the Lord.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. So now I am here to tell you the reason for Believer-a-thon. The reason we are on this air today and all throughout the week, we want to get on Dish Network. We want to get on DirecTV. And the goal is to receive $120,000. Yes, $120,000. And God is able. If you agree with me, let's give it up. Let's give it up. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank
you, we bless you, oh my God.
Thank you, Lord.
You're worthy. And people are already calling in. And people are saying, yes, we're going to stand with you, Bishop Nikki. And we're asking you to be one of those people. We have divided the different ways we can meet our goals. And it's right there on the screen. 120 people give $1,000 each month. 240 people give $500 each month. 480 people giving $250 each month. 1,000 people giving $120 each month. 2,000 people giving $60 each month. 4,000 people giving $30 each month. So there's a category for everyone to be a part. And we want you to call us and let us know how you are going to be a part. You may say, well, I can only give 30. It's okay. We just want you to be consistent. You may say, well, I'm one of those that will give $1,000. God has blessed us in different measures, and you can give even $120,000, the one-time gift, and say, Bishop Nikki, I believe in the vision, and I want you to go forth and get on Dish Network, go forth and get on DirecTV, and I know that this is the Lord's doing. We want to hear from you. And all the different hosts that have been on OCN, a lot of them have asked me, when are we going to be on Dish Network? When are we going to be on DirecTV? This is a time for you to say, Bishop Nikki, I believe in the vision, and I want our programs, along with your program, I want all of us to get on Dish Network. I want all of us to get on DirecTV. I also want to hear from you. Every one of the hosts out there, I also want to hear from you. And you can call me 323-638-2710. Some of you are already calling. Please call. If the line is busy, call again. I want to hear from you tonight. I want to know that you are standing with me. I want to know that indeed you believe in the vision of the Lord. This is God's vision. Go ye into the world and preach the gospel. And this is the fastest way that we can do it, through the television. And if you are watching OCN all the time, you will know that this station, we teach the word of God. Amen. It's not diluted. We teach the word of God. And we do it with simplicity. Yes. It's not about something that others cannot comprehend. This station, we have practical teaching of the word. And it's varieties of teaching, no heresies. You will be blessed. This is a good ground. So we're asking you to call. Tell me, say, Bishop Nikki, I am standing with you. And those of you that may say, well, I don't have $1,000, you may just say, right now I have only $10. I'm going to give what I have. Whatever it is, I want you to call. Let's pull that up again. You can call 1-323-638-2710. 323-638-2710. Also, at the Facebook, write me at the Facebook. We are live right now, so we can call your name. And if you have any prayer requests, we want to also pray with you. Amen? We want you to be a covenant partner with us. Let's all hold hands together. Let's make this happen. Let the nations of the world hear about Jesus Christ. We need your support, your monthly support. And it's so amazing. I'm telling you, the Lord is so good because he does not want one person to be the one doing everything. He wants all of us. You know why? He always has a miracle in his mind. Yes. When he opens the door for you to be a blessing. And this is for you to be a blessing. Amen. And guess what? When you are a blessing, you are in to be blessed beyond your imagination. Amen?
Amen.
So let's give it up. Let's give it up. Let's give it up.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. So we are waiting for your call. While we are waiting for your call, we are going to enjoy a worship song. And when we come back, we are going to talk about those that have given. I want to be able to call your name. If you don't want us to call your name, just tell the operators, don't call my name, but tell them what I'm giving and tell them the prayer request. So stay with us. Tell your friends, OCN Believerthon is on the air.
Amen.
Amen. We'll be right back. Amen.
We welcome you back to this broadcast at the OCN. OCN means Open Door Communication Network. Thank you for tuning in today. And we know that the Lord that has led you to tune in has something in mind for you. We have just mentioned to you that the purpose of this broadcast is to take OCN to the next level.
Amen.
And
Amen.
We are thanking you because we know you have been supporting
Amen.
Through your prayers
Amen.
And your giving.
Amen.
And we're asking you to do more
Amen.
As a partner to this very, very good vision that the Lord has given.
Amen.
So I want to encourage you tonight through the word of God, just for a few moments. And I want to look at what Paul said to us, the believers, in 2 Corinthians chapter 9, just verse 10, that says that he that gives seed
yes.
to the sower also gives bread to the eater.
Amen.
It is you that sow the seed, and there's power in the seed.
Amen.
God did not make any mistake using the word seed
yes.
to let us know what he wants us to do, mm. even with our money.
Yes.
And back in Genesis chapter 1, he made us to know that every seed mm. has the capacity, the power to reproduce.
Yes, yes.
Of its own kind.
Amen.
And this is the same with your money. So as you sow your money, so shall it come back and reproduce the same kind.
Amen.
And that's why the Lord wants you this day to join in this vision and take OCN to the next level.
Amen.
And that will bring the blessings of the Lord upon your life.
Amen.
Paul said, he that gives the seed also gives the bread
Amen.
To the eater. And the same Paul said, if we sow sparingly, we shall reap sparingly.
Yes.
But if we sow bountifully, we shall also reap bountifully.
Yes.
God will never owe you anything.
Amen.
He will pay you back
mm.
just as you give to him.
Amen.
And that is why we are calling on you today
mm.
to do what the Lord wants you to do, mm. touching your heart at this day, at this moment, at this hour, mm. to support these very, very good steps of bringing souls to the Lord.
Amen.
And so we are calling on you today to rise up and make your call at this time.
Mm.
Thank God for those who are already calling in.
Amen.
And we need more because the Lord has touched you through this ministration
mm-hmm.
to know that souls are perishing out there.
My God.
And except we look for them,
mm.
they may never be found.
Mm.
So the voice of OCN is Amen. Going farther and farther than we even imagine.
Amen.
And now is the time to move forward.
Amen.
Because when you sow a seed, mm. the Lord will make the seed. He has the power to reproduce itself.
Amen.
And so we're asking you today, because the Lord himself used his own life
mm.
to let us know the power in the seed.
Amen.
When he said in his word, in John chapter 12, just verse 24, he said, a corn that has fallen into the ground, except it dies,
mm.
will not reproduce.
Mm-hmm.
He used his own life to let us know that we can sow just like the corn that
Amen.
Goes into the ground
mm-hmm.
and will bring back much fruit.
Amen.
And that's how it will work in your money that
Amen.
You are giving into OCN.
Amen.
Because when you give,
mm.
you are calling for multiplication.
Amen.
You are calling for increase.
Amen.
Because the Lord who made it possible for you to have the money
Amen.
Has put it in your hand. And I'm asking you today to let you know that every seed you have given, don't think that seed has left your life. It may have left your hand today to give it out, but
Amen.
It will surely come back to you.
Amen.
Because that is the word. So God is never, never someone you can say that will lie to you.
Mm-mm.
No. So we're calling on you today. Rise up and join in this very occasion of asking you to help in any way the Lord lays in your heart
Amen.
To give. $100,
Amen.
$200, Amen. $500, and make it to be consistent. Even
Amen.
For every month,
Amen.
You do that.
Thank you, Lord.
And I'm asking you to know, or telling you to know, just what the Lord said here, that he who has sown the seed, not only have sown the seed, but also will become the eater.
Amen.
Of the bread.
Amen.
That is the reward of the Lord.
Amen.
And he is the one that multiplies your seed.
Yes.
To give you more seed again.
Yes.
That you may sow. So I'm asking you to sow. Don't ask yourself how much. Ask the Lord how much. He will put that in your heart.
Amen.
We're looking for $120, $1,000, which is much, but not too much for our God.
Amen.
And I'm asking you to be part of it.
Amen.
So we can know that the ministry the Lord has given to OCN is what the Bible tells us in 2 Corinthians 5, from verse 18 of it to 19, that Jesus came into this world because God was in Christ, reconciling the world
Amen.
To himself.
Amen.
And in verse 19, he made us to know, since Christ came in to reconcile you and me to God, and he has finished his work, now he made us.
Yes.
That are left behind yes. to be people also that will bring others
Amen.
To reconcile with God.
Amen.
So I'm asking you that today, no matter how you think God might have offended you, we're telling you to be the one that will be asking God, what will I do
Amen.
To be reconciled back to you?
Amen.
And God will tell you, my son has paid the price
Amen.
That you couldn't pay. He took away your sins and is buried forever.
Amen.
Never to be remembered again.
Mm.
So we're encouraging you today that the work of salvation that Christ came to do, he accomplished it all.
Mm.
And today we have the opportunity to say, be reconciled with God.
Amen.
So that your life will be turned around completely and you'll be someone that will be happy that something has happened in your life,
Amen.
In your family life. Nations are waiting to hear this voice.
Amen.
And we're asking you to be part of the person that will send this word into the hearts of many people that are waiting.
Amen.
So be part of this occasion, and God will surely bless you.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. You know, I want to read that John chapter 12.
Amen.
Verse 24, that Bishop Sam talked about. Verily, verily, I say unto you, except a corn of wheat fall into the ground and die, it abideth alone. But if it die, it bringeth forth much fruit. You know, as he was ministering, the Holy Spirit was ministering to me. There are many of you that have so many needs.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe every one of us here, we can say the same. And the Lord is saying, let go of that seed.
Mm-hmm.
When you plant that seed to OCN, that's a good ground.
A good ground.
But listen to what the Lord is saying. Unless you let that seed go. It's not going to bring about the harvest of what you are desiring.
Expecting, yes.
And the Lord is saying the desires of your heart is in that seed. That desire for your need to be met, the Lord is saying it's in that seed. And it's when you let go of that seed and plant it into the ocean ground, the Lord is saying is going to bring forth
much fruit.
Fruit.
Amen.
Now listen to this. It's not just going to meet your own need. It's going to meet your need exceedingly abundantly. And at the same time, it's going to bring the harvest of multiplication of souls.
Souls, yes.
Increase of souls into the kingdom of God.
Of God, yeah.
So the seed will meet your needs, and the seed will meet the desires of our Lord.
Amen.
Souls being birthed into the kingdom. I'm here to tell you, you cannot beat God in giving.
No.
You know, another scripture that Bishop Sam talked about was 2 Corinthians 5, 18 and 19. Being a reconciler.
Man.
Being a bridge between the individuals and God. And as you sow that seed, you are reconciling multitudes of men and women back to their God.
Yes.
Because that's what OCN is doing. OCN is preaching the gospel, and as the gospel is being preached, many are being reconciled to God. So please honor this prophetic word and give. It's a seed. Let go of that seed in your hand. You may say, well, this is all that I have. Well, the reason it's all that you have is because God has a miracle in his mind.
Amen.
For you.
Amen.
He has a miracle in his mind for you. We are going to listen to a worship song and then we'll be right back. I have a lot of people that are already given and I want to wait. I want to call your name. You can be a part of making this happen. Sow that seed. I know that the Holy Ghost is touching some of your hearts. Bishop, can you pray for those individuals that the Lord is just nudging them by his spirit? Pray for them to release and let go of that seed.
Amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you. A moment like this, you brought us together this way to release your word in the life of people that are listening. And we know that as they have received your word will grow in them.
Amen.
And that they will also know that as we talk about the seed, the seed must leave their hand and go onto the ground.
Mm.
And the Lord said, the seed that was sown is the seed that will reproduce. So as they believe today, let it happen in their individual lives.
Amen.
And in their finances, they will see that increase because they have believed you. And as long as they have believed your word, your word will never go without being fulfilled.
Amen.
In their lives. So, Father, turn things around for them.
Amen.
And they may know that except they release this seed today, they may not see that increase. But since you say when they do, and that's why we're asking them to do. So thank you for their obedience for this day in Jesus' name.
Amen. 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 So we're waiting for you to call. Call us. Call us and enjoy this worship. Amen.
Amen.
Every praise
is to our God.
Shalom, shalom, shalom. Welcome back to Amen. Believe Upon. We are so glad you're back.
Amen.
Woo! Amen, amen, amen. The Lord is good. Okay, now we want to just say thanks to so many of you that are calling. Catherine has called from New Jersey, and she's given $100 every month. Amen. And Sharon is giving $100 every month.
Amen.
Amen. And our beloved sister Sarah is giving $50 every month. Amen. Amen. And we have some others that have called, but they don't want their names mentioned. And it's okay. We have people giving $20, $10, another $20. Actually, our beloved Georgina, all the way from Belize.
Amen.
$20.
Amen.
Oh, the Lord bless you so much. And we have James also called and wants total healing and wellness, and also is donating. My God, have mercy. Before we go further, Bishop, can you please pray for these ones? Let me read off the prayer request. We have our beloved sister asking for long life, Sharon, praying for healing for her mother that's 80 years old.
Amen.
Oh, we'll be 80 years old on Monday.
Amen.
And we also have, let's see, we have Debbie that's asking for her two sons that are relocating from Oklahoma. They need a job, and they need a better life, Jonathan and Stephen. And we have Cynthia that's also asking for us to pray for healing in the family. And we have Jessica is also asking for healing. They diagnosed her with chicken pox. And we know that there's no disease that Jesus has not healed.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And also asking for God's direction regarding a job. And we also have Phyllis wants her daughter to turn around her life and serve the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. And Georgia praying that there'll be no more return of cancer.
Amen.
Amen. And Catherine asking for her son to have a closer relationship with the Lord.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. So let's join our Bishop Sam as he leads us in this prayer.
Wonderful and everlasting Father, when we come to you, Lord, in this way, we are coming because we know you are there listening, and you have heard all these requests that have come before you. Amen. Lord, we thank you because we know people ask from whom they can receive.
Mm.
And you are the only one we know.
Amen.
That when we ask, we receive.
Mm.
Lord, you are a healer.
Yes.
And there's no other healer we know as you. There's no disease that is new to before you.
Mm.
And we are asking today that all that have been mentioned today, you have heard them, Lord.
Amen.
Heal according to your word.
Amen.
Heal according to your name.
Amen.
Heal according to your blood.
Amen.
That have given us the power to receive this healing.
Amen.
You made it possible for us, Lord, to be touched even by your healing power.
Mm.
And so shall it be upon the lives of these ones that have been mentioned even this day.
Amen.
Especially our 80 years that is asking for more health,
Amen.
More life.
Yes.
Father, touch in a new way.
Yes.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And those who want their children to come back to know you.
Amen.
Father, reach out to them.
Amen.
And let them surrender their hearts.
Yes.
Unto you, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
We thank you for this great opportunity to ask. And because we have asked, you have answered.
Amen.
And so we give you the praise today. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen and amen.
Thank you, Lord.
It's done.
Amen.
And we want to hear the testimonies.
Amen.
Please make sure to call us or write us. Write us at P.O. Box 45465. Los Angeles, California, 90045. We believe it's done.
Amen.
So share the testimonies also with us. Amen.
Glory, glory.
Well, we have Minister Sherry. What is the Lord saying to you about Believerthon? You know, Minister Sherry has been with me for a while now, and she's also one of the hosts.
Amen.
Right here at OCN. And I'm telling you, I know of a woman that believes in giving. And she is a giver. She knows the power of giving.
Amen.
And I just want her to share as the Lord leads her. Go ahead.
Amen. The scripture that God gave me was out of Luke 21. And it talks about the widow with the two mites.
Mm-hmm.
It's in Luke 21, and it starts at verse 1 through 4. And it says, "Then he looked up and saw the rich putting their gifts into the treasures. And he saw also a certain poor widow putting in two mites. So he said, 'Truly, I say to you that this poor woman has put in more than all. For all those out of their abundance have put in offerings for God. But she, out of her poverty, has put in all the livelihood that she had.'" Amen. And I wanted to talk about sacrificial giving, and I wanted to give a testimony.
Amen.
My bishop had called me one day, and I had been working in a job that had a contract, and the contract had canceled. And she called me, and I knew it was nothing but the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
She just called and wanted to talk, and I shared with her what was happening, that I wasn't working. I think I was only working one day a week at that time. And she prayed with me. And after she prayed with me, the Lord spoke to me and said, "I want you to give a sacrificial gift."
My God.
And I told God, I said, "Lord, I don't have it. I'm only working one day a week." And he said, "But I want you to give that gift." He gave me the amount that he wanted me to give.
My God.
When I came to church that Sunday, I gave the amount that God had asked me to give. And within that following week, God had blessed me with a job, a traveling job. And not only was I getting a regular salary, but they were also giving me a per diem check.
My God.
For even trust. I was getting two checks.
My God.
For the job that God had picked. So it's, and I'm pleading to all of you that are watching this program. Some of you have a need.
Yes.
Just like this woman, she was honored.
Yes.
Those that had money and that was rich, it didn't cost them anything.
That's right.
But it cost her something to give.
That's right.
And she was honored by God because he saw her.
Amen.
Give all that she had.
My God.
All that she had. And if you begin to give what you have in your hand,
my God,
God will honor you.
Amen.
He will see what you are giving,
my God,
and he will honor that. And I'm telling you, he will bless you.
My God, my
because
God.
Because those that have it, it doesn't hurt them.
My God.
It doesn't hurt them to give out of their pockets.
Mm-hmm.
But those of you that have a need that you want God to fulfill, give it as a sacrificial gift and see what God won't do in
Amen.
Your life.
Amen.
Amen. He will give you overly and abundantly
Amen.
What you can ask for.
Amen.
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 Mr. Sherry, I know you just shared one testimony. I know. I mean, we can stay here all day, all night.
Amen.
She just shared just a little part. She just shared one of the most current ones.
Amen.
She has tons of them.
Amen.
And I'm telling you, she is so sensitive. The only way you can begin to give sacrificially is when you are sensitive to the leading of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
You cannot do it because you will begin to calculate and say, well, I need to pay this and I need to do this with this money. And when the Holy Ghost is nudging you, give, it's because he has a miracle in his mind for you.
Oh, yes.
And it's only when you let go of that which is in your hand, when you have that need, he always prompts you to give something that will almost hurt you. You know, I hate to say the word, Minister Sherry, about hurting. You know that you don't give anything that you feel like is hurting you. The same thing with me. And I know many of you out there that understand the power of giving.
Yes.
You know, not too long ago, actually, this past Sunday in the church, there was a couple, they were having so many torments with their new child, their newborn baby. And they text me and said, you know, Bishop, we need to talk to you, we need to see you, it's really emergency. This was just this past weekend. And the Lord laid in my heart to send a message to them, tell them that all is well. Don't be afraid, all is well. I can pray from anywhere I am and the Lord answers. And so I sent one of the ministers, because I was at work when this was going on. I sent one of the ministers and I said, go there, take a handkerchief, believe the word I'm speaking to you is coming to pass. Take a handkerchief, take an olive oil, just anointing oil, and that is only representing the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Take it to them and lay it upon the child and tell them that Bishop Nikki sent you. Just as God did with the men of old, that out of their body, the handkerchiefs, they came out of their body and people were being healed. I said, I am sending you instead. I am at work, but I'm sending you. So she went there and she did exactly what the Holy Ghost led me to tell her. Guess what? They came to church 24 hours. That was on Saturday. On Sunday, they came to church with a baby, with all smiles. And after the service, they came to me. They said to me, together the Lord laid in their hearts, while all these things were going on, before the messenger came to their home. And they said, the Lord laid in our hearts an amount. And they said they have so many needs. And they talked about it. And the Lord spoke to the husband, to the wife, separately. And they both came together and said, the Lord said, give $700 within 7 days. And listen to this. Bishop Samuel Cable ministered in the church. And right there, he began to release the prophetic word and said, everyone that the Lord is laying in their hearts to come out and give 316, 316 in accordance to John 3:16, come out. And the husband and wife came out. They told me after the service, 316 times 2 is less than $700. Yeah. And that's what the Lord told them. So they are giving beyond the prophetic word. And the prophetic word came to confirm what the Lord spoke to them. But they had, the whole thing here is that they had so many needs. But the Lord said, sow the seed out of your need and begin to thank me and rejoice for what he has already finished. Amen. In the life of their son.
Amen.
I don't know what need you have. See, the Lord knows exactly what you are going through. When he says, sow a seed, a sacrificial seed, at his altar, let this seed begin to burn like incense. He desires to smell this aroma coming from your seed. I'm telling you, there is a harvest that is going to meet your need. Your need may not be financial need. It may be a marriage need. It may be a health need. But God will meet that need. I know of Minister Sherry. She has tons of testimonies she can share with us. And I know that she works in this tremendously. And I'm asking you to call. Call us right now. You may have a need. And I guarantee you, the God that we serve. You know, I think about King Solomon. He told the Lord what he wanted was just wisdom. After he gave thousands and thousands, the Lord appeared to him in the night. There's something about you releasing your seed. That finances, that's your sweat. When the Lord says give, it's because he has something in mind for you that can only be released when you give, especially sacrificially. God bless Solomon. He said all he wants is wisdom. The Lord said, I'll give you the wisdom, but I'll give you much, much more. And we have not yet seen anyone on this earth that has yet compared to the riches that Solomon possessed. But he gave. He gave time and time and time. He gave and he gave just magnitudes of giving in thousands. The Lord honored it. So I beg of you, join hands with us. We want to get on DirecTV and Dish Network. We want you to be a part. Hold our hands and just let's all go together to declare the word of the Lord, the gospel of our Lord and our Savior, our Yeshua HaMashiach, the King of Kings.
Yes.
And he is returning. Amen. And you are a part making it happen. Amen?
Amen?
So join us. Amen. Now, before we return back, and I'm going to have the other ministers to share, we are going to enjoy another worship song because we want to give you time to make a call. Call us and let us know how much you're given and also your prayer requests. Okay? We'll be right back with you. And we are right back. Thank you for joining us. Now, Bishop Peter, what is the Lord saying to you?
Well, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So glad to be here tonight that we're doing this telethon, you know, to bless the mission and the work of the Lord. The Lord is speaking to my heart tonight. The first time I came here, the Lord told me to sow a seed. And I'm going to sow the seed. I'll tell you, the seed that's in my pocket, I was going to send it to the government. And the Lord said, sow a seed.
Amen.
So I'm giving it instead to the Lord. He's the biggest government.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But listen, as I was sitting down here, the Lord reminded me about Hannah. Hannah, the mother of prophet Samuel, she was being mocked. You know, she didn't have no baby.
That's right.
But her maid had babies upon babies upon babies.
That's right.
And she need a seed from the Lord.
Yes.
See, and she went to the Lord and said, Lord, I'm sowing this seed.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the seed that you give to me, I'm going to resow him back into your house.
Amen.
She made a vow out of what she has not even received.
That's right. Woo!
She didn't have it, but she knew that God, that answered her by fire, is going to answer her by fire.
Amen.
And what happened? God blessed Hannah with Samuel. But you know what? She gave as she promised.
Amen.
To the Lord. You might be saying now that you don't have anything. Yeah, you are the one that the Lord is looking forward to sowing seed because you don't have anything. But God wants you to sow a seed out of your need.
Amen.
I've listened to the man of God, the woman of God here,
We are all speaking on the same line.
Amen.
Because the Holy Spirit is one.
Amen.
Let me tell you something. I have, Amen. You know, done some sacrificial giving.
Yes.
And the Lord answered me.
Amen.
Suddenly.
Amen.
I'm telling you, he's a God of suddenly.
Amen.
And he will answer you suddenly.
Amen.
You might not, you know, you might be told that you cannot become anything in life.
Mm.
Somebody say, oh, you go ahead and go to that school, you're not going to get a job.
Mm.
And they talk down on you.
Mm.
But tonight, you have opened the right station.
Amen.
And you are listening to the right telecast.
Amen.
And this is where your answer, your miracle is going to come out.
Amen.
I am telling you as a prophet of the living God.
Hallelujah.
That God has answered your prayer tonight.
Amen. Amen.
All you need to do is activate it.
Amen.
Do exactly as Hannah did.
Amen.
See the result she got.
Amen.
The Bible said in the book of Luke 6:38, give and it shall be given unto you.
Amen.
Good measure.
Amen.
Shaking together. Press down. Running over.
Amen.
Shall men give unto your bosom.
Amen.
With the same measure you have given, it shall be measured back to you again.
Amen.
Let me tell you. We're talking about the God that created the heavens and the earth.
Amen.
The God that owns silver and gold.
Amen. Mm.
He will bless you.
Yes.
I'm telling you, he has used me to prophesy to millionaires.
Mm.
He's used me to prophesy to businessmen.
Amen.
He has used me to prophesy to kings. And it came to pass.
Amen.
And I'm prophesying to you today.
Amen.
Sow this seed.
Amen.
And get out of poverty.
Amen.
Sow this seed.
Amen.
And get out of that disease.
Amen.
Sow this seed. Mm. And get out from this struggling.
Woo.
God is watching over you tonight.
Mm.
Because a miracle is coming your way suddenly.
My God, my God.
I'm telling you, I feel the anointing of the Holy Spirit right here. And I know everybody here, they feel the same anointing. Because this Bible that we read is the authoritative word of God.
Amen.
It said, heaven and earth shall pass away.
Yes.
But my word will never pass away unfulfilled.
In the name of Jesus.
It accomplishes everything that I have sent it to do.
Amen.
I'm telling you now, God is talking to you.
Amen.
And if I were you, I will stand up and I will answer, pick up my checkbook,
my God,
and I will write that check.
Amen.
Oh, I see somebody's about to be blessed.
Amen. Amen.
There's somebody that has been thinking about a business. Halaboku, Shantalaba, Syria. You've been thinking about a business.
Thank you, Lord.
You turn to the right and you turn to the left,
thank
and the door of this business has been shutting on you.
Thank you, Lord. Mm.
But God is sending his prophet to prophesy on you tonight.
Thank you, Lord.
That door is being opened now.
Thank you, Lord.
As you activate it by your giving.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
I'm hearing $300. I'm hearing $300 a month. And that is what the Lord is also planting in your spirit right now. You stand, Roboko Shandala Basira. Stand up and your business will manifest. Even somebody in your family that is sick will receive a miracle.
Thank you, Lord.
A suddenly miracle.
Thank you, Lord.
I tell you, God is in the business of healing,
amen,
deliverance,
amen,
and salvation.
Amen.
Challenge God today. Say, try me.
Mm.
In the book of Malachi, say, try me.
Malachi.
Herewith, if I will not open the windows of heaven and pour you out blessings. God does not lie. He does not lie.
Lord.
God is not hungry. He said, if I were hungry, I would not even tell you. He says, silver and gold belongs to him. And the cattle on a thousand hills belong to him. Do you think God is begging? God is not a beggar. God just wants you to be blessed.
Amen.
Through your obedience. Obedience will bring you the miracles and the suddenness of God.
Amen.
Child of God, I want to pray for you right now.
Amen.
Because I want God to bless you. The bishop wants God to bless you.
Amen.
The men and women of God here want God to bless you.
Amen.
We are all in one accord.
Amen.
So, pick up your checkbook. Don't waste time.
Amen.
Do it on time. Father, in the name that is above every other name.
In the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
We pray for these ones right now that are about to obey you now. They're picking up their checkbook right now and they are writing by faith.
In the name of Jesus.
They are challenging you, Lord. They are trying you to see
in the name of Jesus
if their seed will germinate. Father, you brought me from all the way Africa, Nigeria. Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
And I saw the land that I came out from. When seed fall on the ground, it grows. It's a green land. And your hand is more fertile than the land. Father, I pray your blessing, your hundredfold blessing upon these ones right now.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Satan, I rebuke you.
Yes.
Take your hands away from their
Amen.
Business. Take your hand away from their
Amen.
Family. Take your hand away from their health. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Be healed.
Amen.
Be delivered.
Amen.
Be set free.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Bishop Peter, I want you to pray for Perry. He just called. He wants us to rebuke the spirit of death in their community. 7 people have died since Thursday. This is from Idaho. 7 people have died since Thursday. My God, have mercy.
Praise
this
God.
This is annoying.
Shila
I want all of us to live in that prayer. Let's rebuke that spirit of death.
As the bishop was speaking, I heard the word of the Lord said, you shall not die
in the name of Jesus,
but live to declare
Jesus.
The glory of the Lord.
In the name of
you
Jesus.
Shall not die
in the name of Jesus.
You're gonna declare the glory of the Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Satan will rebuke you
in
right
the name
now.
Of Jesus.
You foul spirit of death in Idaho. We cause you to your rookers. We bind you. We destroy all your devices.
In the name of Jesus.
Now, in the name of Jesus, we command you to pack your bag and baggage and leave them alone. Holy Spirit, we call upon you. Holy Spirit, we call upon you. Deliver your people. We plead the blood of Jesus upon Idaho right now. We ask you, Lord, to send your angels around them. Thank you, Lord, for the safety. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Evangelist, please, can you release the blessing of the Lord to the people as we close out? Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Father God, we are just thanking you right now, God, for those ones that are giving.
Yes.
God, we thank you right now that even as your word has said that they give,
Amen.
You they shall be given unto you good measure,
yes.
pressed down,
yes.
shaken together, and running over.
Amen.
And shall men give unto their bosom.
Amen.
God, we are thanking you right now for every life.
Amen.
Every believer that is sowing a seed tonight, God, we are thanking you for every need being met in their lives,
Amen.
In their families,
Amen.
With their health,
Amen.
With their children,
Amen.
With every business venture,
Amen.
With
Amen.
Every relationship, God,
Amen.
In the name of Jesus,
Amen.
God, we are decreeing
Amen.
Good measure, pressed down,
Amen.
Shake it together,
Amen.
And run it over, God.
Amen.
Shall men give unto their bosom, God.
Amen.
We thank you, Lord.
Yes.
We give you all the praise
yes.
for what you are doing, God,
Amen.
As they continue to sow the seed
Amen.
In OCN, God.
Amen.
They will remember
yes.
as they sow this seed,
Amen.
They will testify
Amen.
And say that it's because
yes.
they sowed it to OCN.
Amen.
That God opened the door for them.
Yes.
Even as this is the open door. our communication. Amen. God, we are thanking you,
thank you, Lord.
Giving you praise for every life, every soul, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God, we thank you, and we bless your name, and we call it done for every seed in Jesus' name.
Amen. Bishop Peter, I have a pastor here that was watching you when you were ministering, and I know him very well in San Diego, Pastor Gilbert Adila, that the enemy has tried to torment with some sickness. And he said, please pray that the greatest seed that they can plant, himself and his wife, is their lives.
Amen.
Pray that he will continue to live a long and fulfilled life. Amen.
Amen.
Please look in that camera and pray for Pastor Gilbert Adila in San Diego. He just called.
Father, in the name of your son Jesus Christ, we pray for Pastor
Adila.
Adila.
Yes.
Gilbert.
Yes.
Lord, a long life and prosperity.
Yes, yes.
In the name of Jesus.
He will live. He
we
will
rebuke
live.
That Satan
yes.
to lose his hold
in the name of
from
Jesus.
This man of God.
In the name of Jesus.
And his wife.
In the name
and
of Jesus.
From that ministry.
In the
name of Jesus. I say, lose them. Let him go. Freedom. Healing. Salvation, covering, protection upon you. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Pastor Gilbert, you will live a long and fulfilled life.
Amen.
You and Pastor Rita, you will not die.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Please join us next day, okay?
Amen.
We are going to be live every day all throughout this week. Know this. God loves you, so do we. Amen.
Amen.
Shalom.
Shalom.